Great. Welcome everybody. Good morning. Really nice to see everybody come along. I hope that you all are interested in potentially either for yourself or for your team looking to upskill into data scientists or machine learning engineers through our AI Apprenticeships Academy. So I'm going to get started. Before I get stuck in, just a nice little resource for you guys to be able to to look into. So on our website, we do have a page all about the AI, basically apprenticeships in data science and AI. So feel free to go along to that if for whatever reason you can't stay for the whole for the whole session. But also it's a really good resource and does talk about all the different apprenticeships available and gives you some quite useful information about what they are, how they work, questions you need to think about, whether it's right for you or your team. So do absolutely feel free to go and have a look there. You haven't come for this, so I'm not going to spend much time on it, but just so you do know who I am. My name's Tony. I head up the training side of our business at Cambridge Spark, and I spend most of my time working with our strategic client partners, helping them to develop programs and solutions around analytics, data science, and AI capability across their workforces. My background is biotech and strategic management, and I've worked in science sector, FMCG, tech, so quite a broad background, but I'm very passionate about learning and coaching and mentoring, probably why I've ended up in this sector. As I say, email address is there. Do feel free to connect with me on LinkedIn if you have any questions, or just want to keep in touch. Cool. Bit of housekeeping before we get started. So for those of you who are interested either in yourselves or even for some colleagues, our deadline for applications for our next start for the Level 7 program, which starts in February 2021, deadline for applications or initial applications is Monday the 16th of November. The induction is Wednesday the 24th of February. So if you are interested, do get onto our website to register your interest. Or if you've got an apprenticeship or L&D or HR contact who handles things internally, get in touch with them and put them in touch with us. And we'll then get started with the registration form. There is a Python and Maths entry test. And then to join the apprenticeship and to see if you're eligible for apprenticeship funding. There is an eligibility and prior learning assessment. Now, I should just say that we do run the same program for some employers where you may not be eligible for apprenticeship funding. So if you aren't eligible for apprenticeship funding for whatever reason, you might not be in England, you might have a data science master's, for example, whatever it might be. There is another option, so we'd be happy to talk to you about that if that's necessary. Cool. So hopefully you all know us, but in case you don't, we are Cambridge Spark. We're a specialist data science and AI education provider. We're actually the only specialist data science and AI apprenticeship training provider in the UK, and we're the only provider of this Level 7 AI data specialist standard. We deliver the full suite of higher data-related apprenticeships. So we deliver programs in data analysis, data science, machine learning, and AI. And we also deliver that at degree level, both as a BSc and MSc. Again, those are all apprenticeship funded. So here's just a quick overview of what we do. In case there's anything in particular that's of interest to you guys. So obviously most of you will be here today to talk about and find out about the Data Science and Machine Learning Engineer Level 7 program. So this is the AI Data Specialist Standard. And we deliver both practitioner training and leadership. And we do everything from sort of you know, entry level programs. So anybody that's an early careers graduate or reskilling and doesn't have programming or data analysis experience, we have programs to cover that, whether it be the data analyst level 4, the BSc in data science. And then we also have programs like this one for those with programming experience or even data analysis or some data science experience. So the data science or machine learning engineer level 7, or even an MSc in data analytics. Right, here's just a quick snapshot of who we work with, because I know that we've got a good number of people from a good number of sectors today, which is great to see. And I hope you can understand from, you know, who we work with that actually the breadth and applicability of the skills that we cover actually are extremely broad, you know, regardless of the sector. And even within each type of organization, you know, some of our learners come from HR, operations, manufacturing, supply chain, data science, data analytics, machine learning, software engineering teams. You know, there is a huge breadth, science, R&D, you know, regulation as well. So there's a huge broad range of opportunities to really drive value out of the data you're working with. And it won't surprise you, top emerging skills and jobs report from LinkedIn 2020. What were the top roles? It was all data related, data analysts, data scientists, data engineers and machine learning engineers. So, you know, there is a huge demand for these roles and a massive undersupply. So there's a big opportunity here. And where it all fits together. So what we're looking today in terms of this specific program is data scientist and machine learning engineer. So it's all about, particularly from the data science perspective, it's all about predictions, looking at developing recommendations, presenting data to really drive decision-making within the organization. And then those who are going down the machine learning engineer route and have an engineering background, it's all about how do we bring those machine learning models and actually put them into production so that they can be used by, you know, internal clients, but also external clients. And how do we make sure that those operations are repeatable and operating at maximum efficiency? And where it all fits in, for those of you who maybe aren't necessarily, you know, working in the sector, but maybe come from an L&D background or are looking to get into the space, the concept of AI, and we call this the AI Academy, because actually it covers both machine learning engineering as well as data science as two different routes. The broad coverage is machine learning within AI, but machine learning is, for example, just the part of data science. Data science does cover machine learning as a concept, but it covers other topics as well, such as natural language processing. So that's everything that goes on behind the likes of Alexa. And then on top of that, you know, there's concepts such as big data and how do we work with big data sets. But also on top of that, even more specialist thing, topics and, you know, tools such as deep learning, where actually you're going to another level of complexity when it comes to actually building machine learning models. So that's hopefully explains what we're looking at. And again, you know, I probably can't highlight enough how important this program and the skills this program is covering is for not only individual organizations, but actually the UK economy. Deep learning, AI, machine learning is becoming a critical skill for the competitiveness for organizations, but also for the economy. And it just shows that actually the impact within you know, the actual economy is actually becoming really significant. In fact, there's, I think, about 83% of AI decision makers believe that the lack of deep learning skills is actually impacting their ability to compete in the market. And 49% are saying that actually the shortage is delaying significant strategic projects. So these skills are critical. And for those of you who will be taking these up, you will be playing a really important role within your organization. And just another example, Microsoft have released a similar report, but actually the interesting thing that they've pointed to is the solutions around this. And, you know, actually many employers typically or historically have been looking at, you know, buying in talent, so to speak, finding talent that already exists and bringing it in, but that's just not sufficient to actually plug the gap that's needed. And there's actually a significant opportunity to use, you know, to upskill existing employees and really drive the, I suppose, the focus of skills development across the organization. You know, there's a lot of roles nowadays which are touching on data, but actually could benefit significantly. And even, you know, reskilling employees who maybe, you know, their roles are not necessarily as, or the skills that they've got are not necessarily as current as they would like to be. Educating employees and using programs like an apprenticeship like this actually creates a huge opportunity for plugging that gap and ensuring that there's a continuous pipeline of talent, and you could play a big role in that. So what are apprenticeships? I'll touch on this briefly for those of you who don't know, but apprenticeships may have a stigma in terms of what they used to be considered, but actually they're a really exciting and impactful way of upskilling employees, new and existing. So they can actually be used for any level of employee. So whether you're 16 or to 100, you can start an apprenticeship, and they're a great option for school leavers or anybody looking to change their career or upskill. You know, they are really broad in what they offer, and are actually over a huge range of actual roles and skill set. And in terms of the funding, so in England, large organizations with wages over £3 million per annum can actually have apprenticeships 100% funded by the government. But for those of employers that don't fall into that bracket, actually, they only have to pay 5% of the cost. So for a program like this, which actually for 15 months of learning is about £17,000, an employer would only have to spend £800-900 to cover that. So it's actually a really attractive option. And this is how it all sorts of fits together. So in terms of the learning levels, level 4 is basically the equivalent of first year and undergraduate degree. Level 7, which is what this program is a master's equivalent. So although you don't actually get a master's with this because it's not a degree apprenticeship, it is the equivalent of a master's in terms of the level of content and learning. So it is a really exciting opportunity, and actually is delivered faster than an MSc. And which program suits who? So if you come from an intermediate or have an intermediate to advanced ability in programming, the data science track, data scientist track will be perfect for you. If you're somebody who doesn't actually reach that level and maybe has no programming experience or beginner programming experience, there is the data analyst level 4, which offers a fast track into the level 7. There is also the BSc data science, which is a 4-year program, which is extremely robust and comprehensive, which could also be an opportunity for you. And if you come from a software engineering or computer science background, the great news is actually you have an opportunity to become a machine learning engineer. So there's a slightly different track for that, but you're bringing your engineering computer science background and supplementing that with the machine learning knowledge that's taught on this program. And this is when this program is released. So we've actually just launched the first cohort of the AI Apprenticeship Academy just earlier, at the end of last month in October. And it's actually been a long time in the making, and it's been a collaboration from a number of organizations, including ourselves and the BBC. But this is really a critical program that, you know, is backed by the UK government, but is designed to tackle a nationwide shortage of data scientists and also machine learning engineers. So this is really bleeding edge in terms of what it does and what's available. So quick snapshot of the program. So it is the only fast track apprenticeship route to learn data science and machine learning. You will focus on gaining a breadth of practical applied skills. It's very much focused around learning skills that you are applying in the workplace. And you cover a really broad number of skills, as I said, in quite a short time frame. So it's a 15-month program and you learn on the job. You'll also have up to three months to complete your assessment at the end. So end to end to get your certificate is about 18 months. And there's two pathways, as I mentioned. So you can come in as a, you know, onto the data scientist pathway, or there's also the machine learning engineer pathway. We typically have this run as an open academy. So you will be with learners from multiple employers, and you will receive a certification from the British Computer Society on completion. And a quick overview of how it works. So who is it suitable for? Well, anybody working with large or complex data sets that might be looking to drive automation, predictive insights through data science and machine learning models. You do need Python and maths experience, or for the machine learning engineer track, a computer science and software engineering background. And it is suitable for employers across England. This is in terms of apprenticeship funding. Now, as I said, if you aren't suitable for the funding, there are other options to still access the same program, but just have it funded differently. And what is it? As I mentioned, 15 months, 3 months for assessment, data science, machine learning techniques. As an apprenticeship, you do have to spend 20% of your working hours on learning activities. I'll go into more detail about that later. It is government funded and you do receive a formal qualification. How do we deliver it? Well, you'll undertake virtual instructor-led workshops, roughly on a monthly basis. There's a real-world simulated projects where you receive immediate feedback on our CAPE platform, and I'll give you a demo of that later. There's also a personal coach that you'll be have allocated to you, who'll be responsible to support you through your learning journey. And you'll also have technical mentors to support you from a technical perspective on, you know, your projects and your application in the workplace. And the training is directly connected to the work you're doing on a daily basis. So you are, this is all about applying those skills in the workplace and building a work-based project portfolio. And requirements for apprenticeships. So these, whatever apprenticeship you're looking at or might want to start, these rules apply. So the number one is you have to be employed in a relevant role. So if you, let's say, were a senior leader and you led teams of data scientists, but actually didn't do much of the work yourself, then that's not going to be suitable for you, because literacy, awareness of the concepts, that's one thing, but application and using those skills on a day-to-day basis is what is critical to an apprenticeship. You need to be able to apply those skills and build a work-based portfolio, project portfolio. So it's really important that you're actually in a relevant role where you will have the opportunity to apply these skills. So that's the first requirement. The second one is, and again, this is an apprenticeship requirement, regardless of what you do, you have to have level two equivalent, so GCSE equivalent English and maths, a grade C or above. If you don't have that already, you will need to complete that by the end of the apprenticeship. And we do offer support for that. So don't worry if that's not something you have at the moment. Experience. This probably works sort of counterintuitively to what you might typically be seen to do, is you might think you need lots of experience to be a really great candidate, but actually it works the opposite way. So if you have significant experience in data science, machine learning, or relevant topics, you actually won't be eligible for this program. And the reason being is the UK government's not going to pay for you to learn something which in theory you already know. So again, this is probably one of those examples of eligibility where you might not be suitable, but actually there is another option where you might not be suitable for the funding, but actually you could still undertake the modules. And again, we would discuss that with you and your employer. So something we could look at. And then the last bit is time for learning. So a requirement of apprenticeships is that you have to spend 20% of your normal working hours on learning. And it has to be evidenced as well. So if you're working a normal full-time contract, that roughly works out to about one day a week. So it's important that you can commit that time, and also your manager and employer agrees to give you that time. It's critical to be able to complete the apprenticeship. So summary of entry requirements: intermediate experience with Python programming, statistics and linear algebra knowledge, and these will be assessed. You have to be in a relevant role where you can regularly apply the skills you're covering. You shouldn't have any significant education or experience in data science or machine learning. And the machine learning engineer pathway, for that specifically, you need software engineering experience or a computer science degree. And this just gives you a quick snapshot of the entry assessment. So there is that initial suitability assessment where we'll try and understand your background, your experience, whether you have English and maths experience and certificates. You'll also have to undergo the Python and maths assessment to understand if you have the right ability. And then we go through enhanced eligibility checks where we'll look at your personal learner records, your knowledge and skills behaviors that are relevant to the program, and we'll recognize your prior learning. If it looks like you're on the cusp, we'll have to have a professional discussion where we'll just understand more detail around what you're doing and what you know. And then there is a functional skills assessment for your English and maths level, which you go through, everybody goes through. And a little bit about the experiential learning process. So we very much focus on a very hands-on approach to learning. So the idea here is that actually you are learning a topic or being introduced to a topic and then actually getting straight, you know, stuck in straight away to how you apply it. So this is very much based on a concept of the Kolb's learning cycle. So that first stage is learning. That's being introduced to a new topic. And we do that through the interactive workshops, which are led by a lecturer. So you'll be introduced to a topic, you'll be shown how it works, how you can use it. And in the workshop, you'll start applying it. So you'll get a really good hands-on experience there. But that's really where you're sort of learning individual concepts and tools. But the next stage is really to bring those all together and understand how you can use that suite of tools to actually do something. So that's the next stage, which is the experimentation phase. And we use that on our educate.ai platform. So I'll tell you a little bit about that later, and I'll even give you a demo. But the idea there is that you can test out all those concepts and tools that you've just learned on a real world simulated project. So on a data set that you'd be working on, maybe in your day to day, how can you apply those? And the great thing with CASE is it gives you immediate feedback. It tells you where your code is wrong because it performs tests on it. And it gives you a score as well. And it gives you recommendations. So it's a really engaging way to learn. And it gives you some comfort in terms of, well, I'm not going to break anything, but I'm also getting the feedback I need to know how to improve. Once you've completed those projects, you're then in a better place to understand, well, I know how to use these, so let me now apply it in the real world. And that's where the work-based projects come into play. So you'll take all that knowledge, you'll apply it, you'll demonstrate how you can apply those skills, and you'll produce something. And that's where there's some return on investment. You know, that time that you're investing, the time that your employer is investing, and also all the learning that you're investing, you'll get to see some return on that and deliver some value and really showcase what you can do. And then the last stage is reflection conceptualization. So this is where we really round off that learning experience. So you have coaching sessions, regular coaching sessions. You'll also be writing up a portfolio. So reflecting on what you've done in both of those, but through both those methods, you'll really round off your learning experience. So it's very hands-on. You know, this is pretty much 75% of your learning is applied. And then, you know, there's about 30%, which is about theoretical and thinking and reflecting. And how do we structure it? So what does a typical month or week look like for you? So it will start off, and we run a module pretty much every 4 to 6 weeks. And a module covers a specific set of topics. So week one of each month or each module, you'll take on a specific workshop. So you'll have one day of workshops. After each workshop, you'll then start working on your CATE assignments. So that's your assignment work here. Week two, you'll then have your second day of the workshops. And again, you'll start working on your assignments after that. And then once you've had a good crack at those CATE projects and those assignments, in week three, there's actually a live coding session. So this is where you will see professional data scientists, machine learning specialists tackle one of those projects that you've been working on. And you'll also have an opportunity to ask questions and get answers. So it's a really good way to round off each module. And then you'll still have another week or two to complete your additional assignments or any project work that you might be working on. and commitment. So it's a 15-month program, so it's significant. You know, you're going to learn a lot of different concepts over a period of time. And I know it sounds like a long time, but actually it flies by, and you'll actually cover a lot within a quite condensed amount of time. So each workshop and each module has about 2 days of training. So that's approximately 28 days that you'll be having to attend workshops. Now, there are recordings available if you can't attend these. So it is great to be there in the workshop because you get live support, one-to-one support as well. But if you can't, there are the recordings available. On top of that, there's a live coding session. So for each module, so you've got 14 of those. And there is a 2-day hackathon, which is a 2-day block where you will work on a real data set and in a team and demonstrate some output. And at the end of that 15 months, you then have 3 months to complete your endpoint assessment. So that will be a half day where you'll present some of your work through your portfolio. And you'll also have a interview at the end of that. So over that 15-month period, all of this, that's where you have to apply that 20% rule. So by the end of the 15 months, 20% of your time, your working time, should have been applied to learning. So that's how it all sort of fits together. So quite a commitment, but and it's important that you know that you can commit to that. And on top of that, there is obviously the CAPE work and assignments that you will need to be doing on top of this. So really important that you can commit to that time. So what is 20% off the job and versus skills applied? So we talk about this 20% time that is known as off-the-job training, and that has to be directly relevant to the apprenticeship. And this is all about new skills and new learning. So workshops, your CAPE assignments, scoping your work-based projects, job shadowing, any research you might do, that's all 20%. The other 80% is where you need to be doing your job, where you should in theory be applying the skills that you've learned here to your work. So actual delivery of your work-based projects, that should be part of this. Applying your skills in the workplace, that's part of that 80%. So that's how the 20 and 80% work. This is a very busy slide, but if you tackle it one line at a time, it will help to explain how the program sort of fits together. So this 20% off the job learning is comprised of the modules. So these are the technical modules, and there's 14 of them that you'll cover over 15 months. In the middle, you have your 2-day hackathon, and all the way through, you'll be working on CAPE for, you know, completing your different assignments. And then all the way through, you'll also have intermittent tripartite. So these are progress reviews with your manager and coach, then coaching sessions, one-to-one with your coach, and those will happen intermittently throughout the program. Now, if at any point you need extra support, it will be there. And all the way through, you'll also have study groups. So you'll be allocated into a study group with other learners where you can support each other. So these could be learners from, you know, your employer, so your same organization. But if there aren't any others, you might even be combined with learners from other organizations. So really great way to actually support each other. And as this is a level 7, you know, master's level program, this is pretty bleeding edge in terms of what's covered. So it's really important that you're staying at the bleeding edge in terms of the topics that you are aware of. So all the way through, we do actually cover academic papers. So we'll take you through academic papers. You'll learn how to read them. You'll learn how to understand the topics covered in them, so that once you've completed this program, and it is really important that you come out of this program with a means of working and learning that you can sustain once it's completed. Because, you know, while we are obviously here to help support you, you want to continue that lifelong learning after this and know that you have the right skills and approach to be able to solve problems and learn new topics and concepts, because this is a constantly evolving you know, sector and skill set. So keeping up to date with the latest academic research is going to be pretty critical to your success. Next is the 80%, you know, the working, where you also receive support. So you do need to build that portfolio of data science projects. All the way through, we are surveying. So this is the opportunity for you to voice your opinions and your feelings towards, and also give us an opportunity to improve. So tell us, you know, what's working well, what you could do with more of or less of. And, you know, absolutely, if you're having a great time, please do tell us as well, because we love to hear that. And all the way through, we will provide constant support through your coach, your technical mentors, and you can also send support queries to our email. If you need functional skills, so you don't have GCSE equivalent or higher in English and maths, you will need to take an exam through during the program. And then once you've completed the 15 months, you reach what's called Gateway, where we say, yep, looks good. You've got everything in place. Looks like you've learned everything you need to. And then you'll move on to your endpoint assessment to complete in sort of month 17 or 18. And then that's the program. So the hackathon is actually quite a cool thing. We've just done a case study with some learners on our GSK Academy. It's on our website. So if you want to find out a bit more about it, do feel free to go there. But it's a two-day program. You'll work in teams in a real life sort of scenario. You'll be applying exploratory data analysis and machine learning on some real databases. Data sets, you'll be collaborating in teams, and the idea is that you will prepare a report of what you've learnt. Hopefully you've tackled and found to come to some solution, and you'll be providing communications back to management through a presentation of your findings. And you'll be supported by really great staff, and we have some really awesome teachers who, you know, comprise of PhDs in machine learning or even data science professionals working in industry, and they will be teaching you, but they also are the ones who put together the e-learning and the curriculum that you'll be taught. So the key thing here is that these are the most cutting edge techniques and tools and concepts, and they're all tied back to real world application. So it's all about you being able to do something in your workplace. You'll also have those coaches who are professionally trained, so they are absolutely the best people to support you. And then on top of that, we have technical experts who will be supporting from a technical perspective, any questions you might have about the projects you're doing, you know, how do you scope your work-based projects? So they'll be there supporting from our teacher and mentor network. And one of the key aspects about, you know, our delivery is that it is virtual, but it is top class virtual. So we, in every class, you will have a lecturer who will be delivering, you know, the knowledge, and then you'll be supported by personal tutors who will be there to answer questions on a one-to-one basis. They will answer them instantly. So at any point during a lecture or a workshop, you have a question or need some support, there is somebody there to help you. It is very interactive and hands-on, as I mentioned. So all the way through the workshops, after the workshops, you'll be working on exercises, you'll be applying your skills, you'll be getting feedback. So it's a really engaging way, an interactive way to learn. And then you will, of course, have those study groups, which you'll also be part of a wider Slack community, both for your cohort, your study group, but even for the general Cambridge Spark family. You'll be part of that, and you'll be able to socialize, share what you're learning on, get support, work together, and problem solve as a group. So the great thing at the end of the program is you actually receive a certificate from BCS, British Computer Society, who are the Chartered Institute for IT. So you'll receive a level 7 artificial intelligence data specialist certificate. And if you pass, you can either pass with a pass, a distinction, or even a merit. And our intention is to try and get you to the distinction and merit levels. That is absolutely our goal. And educate.ai. So it's all about real world hands-on practice. This is our own proprietary platform, which we've developed with funding from the government's innovation agency, Innovate UK. And I'm gonna give you a quick demo. And for those of you who haven't seen it before, I'll just show you what the site looks like. So the URL is educate.ai. So do feel free to go have a look. Get an idea about what it's about, how it works. There's a bit of an explanation about what it does, but rather than just tell you about it, I'm going to give you a demonstration. So here's just a quick example of what a program might look like. And this is a few modules from our level 4 data analyst program, but you can click into a module And within that, there's the learning unit. So I can go and see all the slides that were covered in the lecture. There's all the information there, so I can refer back to it. That's really helpful, particularly on top of the video recordings that you received. And then there's assignments. So these are the different assignments that you'd be able to work on. So you can click into view an assignment. You will see that you can upload a notebook, a Jupyter notebook. So you can download the resources, upload them, and then you get feedback off the back of that. So I'm going to give you a quick demo of how it works. And this is I'm actually going to give you a little tip here. So if you are interested in applying to this program, you will have to go through a technical assessment. And this is a sneak preview of that. So here is some instructions. I can work within the web IDE, so within the browser. And here's an example of one of the projects. So I'm being asked to define a function here. So they want me to understand, to write a function that computes the minimum number of units that are needed to be manufactured by a factory for their process to be profitable. So this is the name of the function, minimum profitable volume. The inputs are selling price, fixed cost, and cost per unit. It's giving me some examples here. Here's some code I prepared earlier. And then I can go to my feedback, and it looks like I'm not doing particularly great. So currently at 4.31%, and it looks like there's some issues on my function. So I've got the evaluation here. 4 out of 11 tests have passed, 7 out of 11 have failed. And I can click into them, and it tells me the test with a high price. So these are the following inputs: selling price, fixed cost, cost per unit. And what I'm really interested in here is that my result did not match the expected value. So I returned 0, the expected value was 1. Okay, I can move on to the next one. Tested with half the cost, again, inputs, and I'm interested in, I returned 1, expected value 2. Okay, same here. So I'm starting to see a pattern. There seems to be a difference about 1 for each one. So actually, if I go and do something very basic and simple, and the great thing with Kate is I can just keep on doing this. I can go back, submit, get some feedback, change my code, submit, and I keep on and continue to iterate and get feedback and see what's changing. So Kate's just generating some feedback for me, and hopefully it's going to tell me some news. Great. So actually, I'm now passing all the tests. So I've submitted here 11.85%. So that's more than doubled. Looks like I'm passing all my tests. And one of the other things that Kate does, it assesses code quality against standards like PEP8 and PyLint. So it'll tell me how I can actually improve my code from a quality and readability perspective. So I can keep going back and actually earn extra points. So, you know, quite an engaging way to learn. I don't have to wait for somebody to review my work, provide me with feedback. I'm really in control of my own learning speed, which is really great. And on some more interesting projects, you know, you get even more feedback. So, you know, your score continues to grow. You can see all the different projects and functions you've been implementing, and you get plenty of feedback on how to develop your code. So, how does this program drive value? Well, you know, as we've talked about so far, you've got this learning phase, you've got that off the job training where you're, you know, understanding concepts, learning concepts. You're then moving on to work-based projects, and this is where you really get to apply the skills you've learned and then finally deliver impact. So there's some great showcases of how you can do that. Now, ultimately, you're building these work-based projects, of which there's two main ones. So you'll go through a process of scoping a project, which would be supported by a technical mentor, and then you'll implement that project over a couple of months. And then that's what goes towards building that portfolio, which you will eventually use as part of your endpoint assessment. And you get plenty of support, as we've mentioned already. You know, you've got that expert-led teaching and support throughout the workshops. You then have your personal coach who will be having regular progress reviews with you and your manager, and then also one-to-one sessions with you on a regular basis as well. So plenty of support there. And then also that expert technical support, both through technical mentors for your projects, but also when you're working on Kate. So if you do get stuck, there is a support function in there. And coaching wise, so as we mentioned, you've got those regular coaching sessions. Those are typically quarterly, but actually if you do have a one-to-one communication channel with your coach, and you can schedule sessions more regularly if you need them. And then on top of that, you do have those progress reviews that also happen on a 12-weekly basis. We'll develop an individual learning plan for you. So this is how we set out with you how you're going to go from where you are at the start to actually achieve the apprenticeship by the end of it. And this is a live document that's managed in our AppTem system. So you'll have access to that. And it's really where you bring all your learning together, and you'll evidence your learning, log your hours, log the learning that you've completed, and also your portfolio. You do have that technical support and mentorship, as mentioned. So educate.ai, you have a ticketing system there. You have your technical mentorship for projects. There's also live coding sessions, and you can ask questions there and see how somebody will tackle, a professional can tackle those CAPE projects that you're working on. An assessment, as you mentioned. So you've got a project report that you'll need to present, and you'll also have to answer questions at the end of the program. You'll also have a professional discussion. It's a 60-minute discussion with an assessor who'll ask you some questions to really understand your knowledge about the topics. And it would really mirror day-to-day sort of work, where you'd have to explain some of your work in a technical way and present your findings and recommendations. And there is actually also a technical test, which could be computer-based or paper-based, which will consist of four long response questions. They'll be based on specific scenarios, and you'll have up to 100 minutes to actually complete it and answer those. And it is closed book, but you will have access to a calculator, pen, and note paper. And one of the sort of added benefits of being part of the Academy is you actually get to join our Cambridge Spark family. So you get to network with some great organizations and learners from some great organizations. And you also get to join our leading alumni and teacher network. We've been running data science courses for a good number of years now, and it's great to see individuals such as Julia here, who actually did our boot camp a good number of years back. And now is leading data science at UniPart, big supply chain manufacturing organization. And she's still very much part of our community and our networks, and has now, I think, 10 or 11 apprentices on the level 7. So it's great to see that, you know, that those relationships really last a long period of time. This is just to reassure you. So if you do fall into the bracket where you don't have GCSE certificates or equivalent, there is a tool there that will help support you, provide all the resources you need, progress check and exam. And I should say that actually it is not as complicated as a GCSE exam for English and maths. So it's pretty straightforward, but you would need to take that exam during the program if you don't have those certificates. So just to summarize the learning experience, we have modules every 4 to 6 weeks, live instructor-led training and workshops, which are all recorded, as are the live coding and support sessions after each module. You've got those online practical projects and assignments on CAPE, virtual classrooms with one-to-one tutor support, immediate tutor support. You have your professional coach who will be there to support you, technical experts, study groups. You'll be applying it through work-based project portfolio. You'll also use that data hackathon as a great opportunity to apply as well. And obviously, again, as those real-world simulated projects on CAPE. Right, so we've sort of rushed through, not necessarily rushed through, but gone through all the details of the program. I have some time to take some questions. So do feel free to pop them in the chat. I'll be happy to answer them. I will stop the recording here. This will go out to everybody after the session. So and do feel free to email me or contact the team. Go on our website, do register through there. And any questions?